What the difference is between a cycle and a force switch. So I want to show you why a cycle has its limitations and how a force switch puts control in the hands of the puck carrier and how the puck carrier can influence the play and create quality chances to score. So here's the first one. So this is the Leafs going to enact a cycle here against Montreal. I'll show you exactly where the limitation is. So we're going to get puck control right here. So in this situation, you can see this guy is covered. This guy here is about to be covered right there. The point's now covered as of right now, so he gives up on the play. So now he sends a puck back down. Okay, and now you can see he's covered here, he's covered here. Everyone has inside position. No one's had to make a decision. So the longer you put yourself in situations like this off the cycle, the less likely it is you're going to be able to generate chances. So you're going to spend 10, 15, 20 seconds in the offensive zone, and you're going to spend all your time moving in the corner here, and you're not going to be able to generate any chances to score because no one, it's very clear who's everyone's responsibilities are. Now when you go to the next clip, I'm going to watch Joffrey Leupel here. He's going to force a momentary switch. So here, he's with him, he's with him, he's with him. So now what we need to do is force a decision. So Joffrey comes off the wall, controlling the pressure. Now when he turns back, as of right now, there's a switch. This defender recognizes that this forward has been beat. And now he has to lend support. So there's a moment in which Joffrey has the attention of two players against one, which leaves a play here where temporarily Kuhlman is wide open. That's effectively a force switch. Now let's take a look at the next clip. All right, so here's another force switch. So this is Chicago's fourth line. As of right now, we got good defensive zone positioning by Boston. Once the puck comes down, Lucic leaves his guy, comes here. Now this guy recognizes it, turns his skates. So now, as of right now, Lucic is beat. So that forces a decision. Someone has to pick him up. So they're going to leave their responsibility. As soon as they do, this Lucic is beat. This guy has to switch his responsibility. And now you see the defenseman engaging. Once a defenseman engages, that's really this guy's responsibility. Watch what happens. Everyone has to make a decision. Who's my guy? What do I need to do? Where am I supposed to be? And that gives you a good puck in the middle of the ice with a clear lane to the net. Last one I want to show you is right here. So here's Patrick Kane. He's going to engage the cycle here. What the idea is that he's going to have his guys locked up on him, and then what he's going to do is engage also this player by bringing the play up the ice. So here he is, comes up the ice, he's engaged with this player, and then as he comes across the top, he forces a decision by this guy. By forcing a decision, this guy becomes open, and now he's left with a clear lane to be able to shoot through. That's the difference between a cycle and forcing a switch.